Nuttyitonline.com/livewire.
Yeah, just heads up, I'm not helping you clean it up. Okay?
I need to find gloves, too.
I'm not going
to
help you clean that up. Hawks!
I'm not even listening to you, too.
Scott told the tale.
Now I'm going to fart in studio because I'm pissed off.
Well, it's not Josh's fault.
Yeah, why should I have to suffer?
Why should all of us have to suffer with that weird, Chernobyl butt of yours? 1-800-767-1098. Hawks have descended on the city. Scott's backyard was covered in feathers, flesh, speckles of blood. They descend, they attack, they fly off. We got photos from people, tweets, emails, texts. And then the minute we said to call, phone lines exploded of people.
Yeah, I got a bunch of texts.
What do you got there? 56332.
Walked outside this morning. A red-tailed hawk was fighting a squirrel in Arbutus right in front of my townhome.
That's a fight that squirrel loses.
Squirrels can be very vicious.
I was going golfing in Clifton Park, and I saw a hawk fly down and pick up a squirrel. It was amazing to see. My friend who works as a UPS driver was running across the front yard. The owner of the house opened the door. A chihuahua ran out, and seconds later, a red-tailed hawk swooped down and flew off with the chihuahua.
Have you ever seen the hawk mountain goat videos?
Yeah.
Where they grab a mountain goat and will shove it off
the cliff.
It'll fall like 6,000 feet.
Die, and then they just go down and they eat it. Isn't that amazing?
That's so scary.
It's ingenious.
And the thing, it'll follow the thing as it falls and then lands and they nibble on it.
There was a hawk in the northeast part of the city. We watched it a while it stalked a huge pigeon. It managed to grab it with one claw, fly to a power line, and proceed to tear it into pieces as we watched, all while standing on one claw.
Mike, I need you, the video, the Golden Eagle dragging mountain goats off cliffs is next level horrifying.
Well, we have to remember, these are essentially dinosaurs, or the closest thing we have left to them next to, I guess, crocodiles and...
And, I mean, we don't know if these are hawks or falcons. We're getting a bunch of different, you know,
it's
texts
a bird.
And calls, whatever. It's a bird of prey. There's birds of prey. Falcons
raptors.
Were raised at the old Legg Mason building. Every year they nest at the same window ledge when it was the Legg Mason building, and they monitored it. They had a monitor in the lobby so you could watch the babies grow up. It was well documented.
Mike, watch this son of a bitch. What, have you ever seen this?
Oh, yeah.
Watch this evil bastard grab this goat by the neck and throws it off a mountain. What a bastard. Oh, I mean, look at it go.
It's dragging it.
Oh, God. Oh, look at it flail through the air. Oh, nature's awful.
One more text here at 56332. I live in the city. I was kicking back with a beer in the yard. My 24-pound cat was sleeping in the grass.
I don't want to hear that.
A hawk swept down within 2 feet of it and then flew off. I guess it realized it was too big and aborted its mission.
Oh, yeah, good luck. Good luck trying to kidnap my fat ass. That is not happening. That cat isn't going anywhere. That hawk's going to dislocate its limbs. Let's go to the phone, 1-800-767-1098. Ryan's been holding for a bit. Ryan, good morning.
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 All right, so I was driving through Wheaton the other day, and I stopped right before a bridge, and I seen like this little pigeon on the sidewalk.
Mm-hmm.
So this hawk swoops down, grabs this pigeon,
mm-hmm.
and at first, you know, I'm thinking it's pretty cool. And, next thing I know, the pigeon dropped on the hood of the work van.
Ooh.
And, you know, out of reaction, I get out to go get the pigeon off, and I get about 2 inches away from grabbing this pigeon, and this hawk swoops down.
Whoa!
And grabs this pigeon off the hood.
Whoa! Just snatches it out. Like, how close did it come to you?
Oh, man, if I was another inch closer, it would have grabbed my finger.
How big was it in person? Were you, like, stunned by the side, like, when its wings are open? I mean, I imagine the wingspan's got to be 4 feet.
They're not, you know, small by any means.
God, it's amazing.
Thank you for
talking about doo-doo in the trousers.
Oh,
and isn't it amazing how much blood can be in a small bird, like a pigeon like that? They got a lot of blood in them.
Oh, yeah, they do.
I was going to say, it probably popped like a water balloon filled with fruit juice. In this video, Mike, we're going to put this video at the Morning Show website.
Oh, yeah.
It's not just the wingspan. Look at the meat around its legs. Its legs
strong
are like pit bull muscles.
And them talons.
And those talons are like steak knives.
They're killing machines. They're designed for. They're
birds
of prey.
Look right here. Watch when this thing swoops in. Look at the legs on that son of a bitch. It's like a raptor.
Yeah,
huh? That thing needs to be in Jurassic World. All right, let's get another phone call here. Line 2, Mike, Frederick, good morning.
Morning, guys. How's it going?
How you doing, bud?
good. Listen, I lived out in California. This is nothing new. Modern conservation efforts are going to be continually raising the wildlife populations. And you think about the streets of Baltimore, how much they resemble the canyons that hawks like to hunt.
They'll hang
up on the buildings, watch down below for, and pigeons. I mean, dear God, it's an easy food supply.
But it seems like in Baltimore, I don't know, maybe it has been going on for a long time, but it's just got, you know, popped up on our radar because I had feathers in my backyard the other day. But it seems like more and more this seems to be happening around here.
I think that's true. I grew up in this area, spent my whole childhood out in the woods, hunting, fishing, playing, you know.
Yeah.
We were always outdoors. Never saw a coyote, never heard a coyote, never even saw traces of them. I've seen three of them since I moved back to California.
They're everywhere. They're in the city now. Foxes and coyotes.
Wildlife is kicking back. For a while, you know, for 100 years, a coyote was shot on sight in this area.
Mm-hmm.
And so things are going to get better. But
Did you just make all of that up? Are you making all of this up as you go along, mister?
No, I don't know.
I don't believe any of this.
I wanted to warn Justin if I don't know what color your cats are.
Uh-oh. Oh, God.
But in California, nobody has a white cat or a small white dog and lets them out because they will get picked off.
Oh, my God. Both of my cats are white.
Just like
my friends. Oh, no. Let's go to line three. George Hampstead, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. How are you?
Good. I have a couple of hawk stories for you. Actually, I have a couple of dog stories, but first,
pick the best one.
I understand what Scott's fear was, because the first time I saw that thing with the bird, I looked all over for the bird, couldn't find, just found feathers. So I know I found it several times since. But anyway, the neighbor two doors down had her dog swooped up, and the guy that works, for me, he was standing tall. He lives in Manchester, and he was talking to his neighbor, and while he was talking to her, a hawk swooped down and got her chihuahua. And he owns this is a good story here. He owns a Shih Tzu, and a hawk. He lives, like I said, is right next door where the dog swooped up, and the hawk swooped down to try to get his dog. And his dog leaped up in the air at the hawk and actually scared the hawk off.
Wow!
Now, when you say grab the dog, did it take off never to be heard from again?
That dog's gone.
Never to be heard from again.
It's gonna happen to my dog. It's gonna happen, dude. My dog's 4 or 5 pounds tops, and I let him out in the backyard. Sometimes I let him out on the front sidewalk. He'll run down like three doors down and go take like a pee on one of the trees and come back.
Giorgio.
And he's going to be run down the sidewalk one day. And he's going to be gone.
I've been telling you for years you have to supervise that dog.
Yeah, but I didn't believe you. But now I think the fear is real. This is real now.
Ankle weights. You got to weigh him down, Melissa.
Something, yeah.
Pennsylvania. Good morning, PA.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So I have a good hawk story for you.
Oh, it better be good.
Yes. So I'm standing in my carport one day, and it's one of the windiest days of the year. It's whipping. And I'm standing out there, and all of a sudden this bird gets blown into my carport. So we're checking out the bird, making sure he's okay, and I start to try to shoo it out of my carport, and my husband notices that there's a hawk sitting in a tree not far from where we are.
Just watching.
So I start shooing the bird out, and next thing I know, this hawk starts going towards the bird. But the wind caught the hawk, and it blew the hawk directly into my chest.
Oh, God!
What?
Did it make off with your nipple, never to be heard from again?
38online.com.